Hi guys, welcome back to yet another video, and I want to talk about what you call change of profession in Qatar. Most of you have requested what you call change of profession in Qatar. Yes, the person who asked this question, you did not tentatively try to classify exactly what kind of profession, but we have two kind of professions. Maybe shifting yourself from the normal profession to a bigger profession, which is called on the profession level, or we are looking at changing the profession from what we call in the QID, let's say from a security guard to another profession. Yes, those are two situations that we definitely need to talk about, and what are the requirements. Yes, when we look at the best requirements for you to have for change your profession, first of all, it has to be you, the person who is going to change. By the way, if it's your first time to come across this channel, don't forget to subscribe. It's next from the next question giving you all the updates. Let's go straight into the video. Yes, change your profession in Qatar. What do you need definitely to do? Yes, most of us come to our countries, we have those papers, and we think we have the better qualification to have better jobs here, which is the case, or which may be the case, which is true and which is right. But there's a lot of procedure that you need to follow. Oh, there's a lot of sequences of procedures for which your papers must go through. Yes, let us look at a person who is coming from home, and you are aiming at one day, I'll change profession from one job to one which is a little bit skilled, which has my skills, my education, and my requirements. This is a piece of advice I'll give you. When you are coming, make sure you ascertain all your papers. Assertion of all your academic documents should start from home, from your university, from whether your institution or your tertiary institution where you had your education from. Then those papers should go to what you call the Ministry of Internal Affairs. They will be stamped, ascertained, and sealed. Then those papers, you'll bring them as you're coming to Qatar or any other Arab country that you're coming to the embassy that represents your country in that country, they represent your country in that country. They will stamp them to verify that there are true copies of what we call the originals. Then you pay a given amount of money. For Ugandans who are in Qatar, for you to have an accepted copy of your document, it's around $120, $110 that you need to pay for every copy that needs to be stamped and ascertained. So after getting that ascertation stamp from the minister of the embassy that represents your country, then those copies will be taken to the Ministry of Interior or for stamping. They will be taken to ascertain, to be approved, or to be approved that the original copies of the original of the original. They will get a stamping and you will get a seal. So those papers are valid to be used into the country, which most of you do not want to follow. The biggest problem that we have is that these papers will be followed up from the start to the end. So make sure that the papers that you tentatively tend to give for stamping until to the end in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs must be true copies and must bear those documents or must have those results there from where you got them from. So, and something definitely I also need to share out. Most people fear paying up the money. Fear spending up money and paying up the money. Let's say, for example, $120, $111. But if you are really planning for something ahead of you sometime, then paying $110 or $200 or $120 is no problem. You get the papers ascertained for that. Then let us go to straight and look at you changing your profession in your ID. That profession you're changing into your ID, you are changing from a security guard to what you call an assistant manager. This is done for free of charge. It is done for free of charge. However, something that you definitely need to understand, it has to be done by your employer. They are going to look at your former occupation, your former contract of your former occupation, and your current occupation, which you are recruited in, including your academic documents that has to be ascertained by the Minister of Labor. They'll be submitted to the Minister of Labor for approval, and then your change will be changed in the ID. But remember, most of the time, this application has to be done by what you call your employer. Your employer has to do this application for it to be changed on your QID. So if you've been as a security guard and you've got another role as what you call, let's say, for example, manager, yes, they will have to change the details, change your profession from the security guard to a manager in the QID, and those ones has to be done by the Minister of Labor, approved, and then the Minister of Interior in printing the document. Then it will be shown that you'll be approved and it will be changed, but after submitting those documents to the ministry. And this has to be under the supervision, or has to be what you call your employer. Your employer, because he needs, they need the signature, and they need those former contracts that you had, and copies of what we call the former, the previous documents. Then they'll definitely sign it and you'll be changed. Once it is changed, your new ID that you're going to get, it will have the profession, the new profession, not the old profession. By the way, it will also depend on what kind of job you are going to do, which company you are going to work for, and what kind of job that you are going to do. So definitely, you find that you don't pay a single coin. But however, it is your employer himself has to be that person that has to push it, follow up until you can be done and you can get your ID, and change of it all will be approved and you get it. And once your change of profession is approved, definitely in Metrash, you definitely have that one. You will get it that your change of profession has been approved from here and here. And you can still even check your ID. Once you get a new ID, you definitely have to translate and see the profession. It will be changed automatically within the system. And that is how definitely things work here. They work so smart with the system, and you definitely know that you are going to get the best out of it. Hope I've tried to answer your question. If there's any query and there's something that you really don't understand, please, you can come in my inbox. You let me know. I can get into your person and give you more clarification on one or two things. Thank you. Thank you so much. See you again in the next video. And thank you so much. See you in another video.